I call them Igmos. A couple of years ago, I made up that word. You can use it tonight. I'll leave you with it. Igmo. It's a cross between ignorant and moron. Now, Mark Twain said years ago that everybody's ignorant about something. And that's true. You know, I'm not talking about that kind of ignorant. You know, Louis Grizzard said once that there's a difference between naked and naked. Naked is when you don't have any clothes on. When you naked, you ain't got no clothes on and you up to something. And that's the kind of ignorant I'm talking about. I'm not talking about somebody that's ignorant of something. That means that you just don't know something. I'm talking about ignorant. I-G-N-E-R-T, ignorant. When you're ignorant, you don't know something. There are people that do and say the strangest things. You know, I met a big Igmo the other day. Super Bowl Sunday, had a bunch of people over my house. Last Super Bowl, biggest Igmo I met all year. I said, well, I'll treat. I go down and went down to the chicken place, walked in. I said, I want 12 buckets of chicken, 2 gallons of Coca-Cola, 6 ears of corn, 14 packages of fried okra. A little girl looked me right in the face, said, y'all go eat that here, take it with you. I said, well, we'll get it to go, Igmo. What an Igmo, you know? Last woman I dated was an Igmo before Bubbalicious came into my life. I got it over with. I'm walking out. She said, Bubba, you ain't never gonna find another woman like me. I turned around and said, well, you know, if I don't want you, why not I want another one just like you? Igmo! We in Tootsie's Lounge during fanfare. Up there on Broadway in Nashville, place is packed out. There's a bunch of people standing around the walls waiting for tables. Me and Bubbalicious are having an adult beverage. We started talking to these people next to us, and they got up and left. You know, waitress come over and bust the table. There's nothing on this table. A couple walked over from the wall and tapped me on the shoulder and said, excuse me, but are the people that were sitting here still sitting here? I said, yes, they are. They've gone into invisible mode. Don't sit on them. I'm coming out of the beach the other day. I don't wear my watch when I go in the beach. There was a guy laying there on the sand. He had a wristwatch on. I said, sir, do you know what time it is? He said, you mean right now? I said, no, here's my cell phone number. Call me in an hour and 14 minutes. Tell me what time it is. Igmo! Oh, there's lots of fast food Igmos out there. They work in these fast food places. That's a breeding ground for Igmos. They have little hatcheries in the back that they breed Igmos out, stick them out there. Lady walked up to Taco Bell place. She said, I'll have a taco grande with minimal lettuce. Little girl said, the only kind of lettuce we got is iceberg. I'm in Salina, Kansas one day, walk in a Dairy Queen. I said, hey, I said, I want a hot fudge sundae with extra hot fudge. Little boy said, what? I said, I want a hot fudge sundae with extra hot fudge. He said, our hot fudge only comes in one temperature. What a egg. I just turned around and walked out on that one. I said, I can't deal with this. I just can't deal with it. 2 days before Thanksgiving, I'm gonna smoke me a turkey. I love smoked turkey. So I go down to the local grocery store and walk in. I want a fresh turkey. There's a lady back in the back at the turkey bin. I'm walking down the aisle and I saw her and I stopped to watch. This is a real Igmo here. This woman was feeling turkeys. Now I've seen people thump a watermelon and feel a cantaloupe, but I ain't never seen nobody feel a turkey. She's taking turkeys out of this bin and feeling them like this. And she didn't like it, she'd put it over here. She'd reach it and she'd get another one, she'd shake it up a little bit and feel of it a little bit. I'd never seen anything like that in my life. That little boy who worked there, one of the stock boys, standing there leaning on the broom, just looking at her like this. I had my t-shirt on, he said, hey, Bubba. I said, hey, Bubba. And we just watched her. She got a turkey out. She'd feel it. She'd put it over here. She got all the turkeys out of this bin. Every one of them's gone. She got 57 turkeys lined up all the way around. She turned to that little boy. She said, "Do you work here?" He said, "Yes, ma'am." She said, "Son, did these turkeys get any bigger?" He said, "No, ma'am. They're dead." He looked at me and said, "Igmo," and I said, "Igmo, boy, that's a big Igmo there." Yeah, the pie, I helped him put all them turkeys back in there. Of course, McDonald's is a big breeding ground for all Igmos in the future. You can't go in McDonald's and not meet an Igmo. I walk in there one day, I said, "I want a hot apple pie and a vanilla shake." Little girl said, "Y'all want dessert with that?" What an Igmo that is. I went in there about 2 weeks ago to get me some chicken McNuggets. I had never tried them. I won't try them McNuggets. Now, which kind of bothered me because I don't know exactly where on the chicken the McNuggets would be located. I guess somewhere between the McGizzard and the McLiver, there's a McNugget there. But I walked in. I read the sign. I told the little boy, I said, "I want a half a dozen chicken McNuggets." He said, "Can't do that. They only come in 6, 12, and 24. I had a live one here. I was going to have fun with this one. I said, "You mean you can sell me 6, but you can't sell me a half a dozen?" He said, "I can't sell you a half order or nothing." I said, "Can you say Igmo?" He goes, "Igmo?" I said, "That's right." And I left. I wasn't going to deal with it. You know, they're just everywhere out there. I meet a lot of Igmos on airplanes. Oh, I travel a lot so much. You know, I've just always meeting people on these airplanes. I was flying from Atlanta to Pensacola about 2 weeks ago. Now, for those of you that are not from here, don't know your geography, I'll explain this to you. From Atlanta to Pensacola is a non-stop flight. About 20 minutes. Right there. That's it. There ain't nothing in between worth stopping at. We sitting on an airplane, plane taking off down the runway. We got 10 feet in the air. Guy turned to me and said, "Going to Pensacola?" I said, "No, I'm going to Canada. I'm flying to Florida to rent a car." He didn't say anything to me all the way here. I wrote Igmo on a piece of paper and showed it to him. We started to get off the plane. He's a little perturbed. He said, "What do you do for a living?" I said, "I'm a comedian." He said, "A comedian?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Well, you don't look like a comedian." I said, "I've been sick." And they make the strangest announcements on these airplanes. I love these announcements. Some Igmo made all these announcements up, I guarantee you. I love it when they take off. I have more fun with this. And they start giving announcements on what to do in the event of an emergency landing. First thing they say, and they even have a picture of it here, they'll come off and they'll say, "In the event of an emergency landing, place your head between your legs." Well, I can't do that. That's about as far as I can get, brother. I'm gonna die. You know, besides that, who wants to die like that anyway? When I go, I want a better view than that. Can you imagine what they say when they found your body? Man, what do you reckon he's doing? I don't hold up like that thing. Look like a cold cat, doesn't he? And then the other one. they got. They said, in the event of an unlikely event. Everything's an unlikely event. Nothing is a likely event. The unlikely event, the cabin should lose its air pressure. An oxygen mask will fall out of the ceiling. Place it around your face and breathe normally. That's the word I have a problem with. I am heading towards Earth at 600 miles an hour and certain death. I got no oxygen and they want me to breathe normally. I'm gonna be sucking on that air hose like a hippo in a marathon. And if there's a small child sitting next to me, I'm gonna take his oxygen mask too. He got little lungs, let him go for it for a while. Bunch of Igmos work for that place, I ain't tell you. I'm in a convenience store out on the island a couple weeks back. Walked in there to get my daily Diet Coke and 4-pound hot dog. I can put 3.5 pounds of chili on a 0.5-pound hot dog. I am an expert at that. I'm in there getting my little daily thing, and there's a man standing there that obviously was not from here. He was one of our Turons. That's a cross between tourist and moron. And a Turon was standing there with his wife, Turoness. And you could tell he wasn't from here. He'd done cut the sleeves out of his black and red flannel shirt, lopped his blue jeans off, really uneven about right here, and had a pair of sandals on with black socks. Looked like a 6-foot duck. They stand there reading the sign above these aluminum coffee mugs, these coffee holders, these real nice things, you know, that you get when you ride down the road, keep your car coffee hot in your car, you know. Had a sign there, said $8.95, $6.95 would fill up. So he looked at his wife and he said, honey, why you reckon it's $2 cheaper if I fill it up with coffee? Oh, this was gonna be good. I stopped building my hot dog about then and started listening. She said, I don't know. She's looking at it. She said, I don't know. Maybe they're advertising the coffee, but if you can save $4, get two of them. So he did. And brought them up to the counter. The girl behind the counter looks at the thing, rings it up, $18.93. Well, that made the man mad. He said, the sign said $6.95 would fill up. She looked him right in the face and she said, oh, do you have gas? Now the old man's really confused. He said, no, I don't have gas. If I had gas, I'd have got tons. I stepped in the middle and I said, excuse me, I live here. Let me treat you with this. I love this story because if you ever listen to the Grand Ole Opry, you're going to hear it again.